morning, children. Welcome back to part 2 of grammar session, and the name of the topic is verbs and their uses. Make sure, children, that you are going to sit with a book, pen and a grammar textbook in your hand. Now, children, before we could start our part 2, let us quickly do a revision on what we did in the previous video, and then quickly we will take over with the part 2 session. So in the previous video, children, we started with the topic verb. Now, what do you mean by verb? A verb is a word that denotes an action, right? If I say birds fly in the sky, so what is the action over here, children? Fly. And when we come across a word, something like Sita is a dancer. Now, is basically a word which denotes that Sita is a subject over here. And it is emphasizing and telling us the fact about Sita that she is a dancer. So it shows that that particular verb predicates a fact, right? Now, children, in the previous video, we also did kinds of verb. Now, children, what are the kinds of verb? As we know that there are two kinds of verbs, main verb and auxiliary verb. Now, what are the main verbs, children? Main verb means the particular verb which denotes an action by itself. For example, she finished her lunch. Finished, okay. So this particular word is denotes an action by itself, and that is the reason this is called as a main verb. Now, we also did what are the auxiliary verbs, children. Now, in auxiliary verbs, there are three types. Yes, the first one is being verbs. Now, what are the being verbs, children? As we know, there are 8 types of being verbs. And what are these, children? Is, am, are, was, were, be, being, and been. So, whenever you come across few verbs with these particular words, that means these are the being verbs, right? Now, the next one, having verbs. What are the having verbs, children? Now, when certain verbs implies the possession, okay, and when we come across few words like has or have or had, which is a past tense of has or have. So, yes, when we come across these kind of words, these are the having verbs, right? Now, children, we also did doing verbs. What are the doing verbs? Doing verbs are basically used to ask questions, right? And they are also used to show some emphasis. Now, when we come across few words like does, doesn't, do, don't, did, didn't. So over here, we are also using the negative sentences, right? Or negative word. So when we come across these kind of words, basically these are the doing verbs. Yes, children. So we had done the part 1 till here. So now we will quickly continue with part 2, and let us see what are the new activity that we are going to do today. Children, let us start with part 2. Our first topic is kinds of principal verbs. Now, the first verb is transitive. What do you mean by transitive, children? These verbs require an object. Children, just make sure that these verbs require an object. And what is a verb, children? Verb means an action. That means to complete an action, we need an object over here. To complete their meaning, or you can say they denote an action which do not stop with the subject but passes on to other pronoun or noun. Okay? So now, let us see, children, how we can do this. There are a few examples over here. The first example is Neeta sings a song. Okay. Next, Hari writes a letter. The horse kicked the boy. Okay. Now, the underlined words here are transitive verbs. Why, children? Let us check why these are called as transitive. Now, if you check, children, Neeta's action of singing is actually passing on to song, right? So over here, song is the object, right? Next, Hari's action of writing. What was the action of Hari, children? Writing. So the action of writing passes on to a letter. So what is the object over here, children? Letter. Next, the horse's action of kicking passes on to the boy, right? So what is the object over here, children? Boy. So now, children, it was really easy to understand these words, that means the circle words like song, letter and the boy are object, and the verbs, basically the action over here, was singing, writing and kicking, right? Okay, now let us go to the next. Now our next topic is intransitive verbs. Now, as we know, children, for transitive verbs we do need an object, but when it comes to intransitive verbs, they do not require an object, children. Okay, make sure that they do not require an object. To make sense, or you can say the verbs denote an action which stops with the the subject and does not pass on to any other noun or pronoun. Now we will just check few examples, children. Okay, now the first example is the baby smiles. Okay, next, the king laughed loudly. Next, the stars twinkle. Now these underlined words are intransitive verbs, children. Why? Let us check. Now the action of smiling of baby stops with the baby, isn't it? Yes, children. After that, no object was being mentioned, and that is the reason this is called as an intransitive verb. Next one, the action of laughing stops with the king, so there was no object. Next, the action of twinkling stops with the stars, so there was no object over here. So there are no objects in these sentences, and that is the reason, children, these sentences are called as intransitive verbs. Now, children, the next topic is verbs of incomplete predication. Incomplete predication, children. Okay. Now, there are some verbs, both transitive and intransitive, that do not make complete sense even after taking the object. That means they mean to say, in spite of having the object over there, these particular sentences, you know, do not make a complete sense. So they need some words to complete the predicate. Okay, now let us see few examples. Now, children, the first example is they elected him king. Now, children, over here, elected is an action. Whom they elected? Him. That means we have a verb, the object over here, right? So it is a transitive verb. However, we have added one more word over here, which is a king, right? Next one, the judge found him guilty. Found over here is an action. Found whom? Him. So him is basically an object, so that is a transitive verb, right? But still we have added one more word over here, which says guilty. Next one, the king set him free. Now set is an action again. Him is an object, it's a transitive verb. However, we have added one more word over here, which is free. Okay, now let us see what detailed information this particular incomplete predication is giving. Here the underlined words are transitive verbs. Yes, we have already checked it, because each verb has an object. Yes, children, we have also checked this one, but still each of them need an additional word like king, guilty and free. Why, children? The reason is we need to complete its predicate. So such verbs are called verbs of incomplete predication. Okay, next one. Now the next sentence, children, you look cheerful. Okay, look over here is an action.
After the action, there is no object. Right? Next. Ramu fell ill. Now, fell is an action over here. After fell, there is no object. Next. The dog went mad. Went is an action. However, there is no object. That's the reason, children, these are intransitive verb because they do not have an object. But each of them need an additional word. And what are these additional words, children? Yes, cheerful, ill, mad. Why we need all these words? To make complete its predicate. To complete its predicate. So these verbs are called verbs of incomplete predication. Right, children? I hope you are clear with this. Now, very important point, children. Just remember, a transitive verb always has a doer. Okay, that means it always has a subject. And it also has a receiver. That means a direct object of the action. Okay, second point. An intransitive verb has no receiver of the action. That means it doesn't have an object. Next, linking verbs are always intransitive. Linking verbs are always intransitive. So these are very important points which you need to make a note of. Now children, let us do one activity which is on page number 34 from your English grammar textbook. Underline the transitive verbs and circle the intransitive verbs. Okay, now children, very important point. Whenever we are going to check whether this particular sentence is transitive or intransitive, there is a trick. Now we will see what has to be done. Now, whenever we come across a transitive verb or a transitive sentence, immediately after the verb, that means after the action, we need to ask two questions. Okay, and the question could be what, okay, and whom. Now, what is generally asked whenever it's a non-living thing? And whom is asked when it's a living thing. Now, how to do this trick? Let us quickly check. Now, the first sentence. The old man walks slowly. Okay. Next one. Raju cuts an apple. Next. Rivers flow into the sea. Next. Maya recited a poem. Next. She knocked at the door. Now children, if you know the answers for this, make sure and you can try and write the answers in your notebook. However, we will also check with the answer keys. Okay, now let us check what is the correct answer. Okay, now the first one. The old man walks slowly. Now children over here, what is your action first? Make sure that you are going to check what is the action. The action is walk, right? So now, immediately after walk, you need to ask the question, walk how? That means how this man is walking slowly. So are we getting the question with what and whom? No. Okay. So what was the question we asked in our mind after the action? It was how. So that means this particular sentence doesn't have an object. So it is an intransitive verb. Okay, now let us check the next one. Raju cuts an apple. Now, what is the action? Cuts. After cuts, immediately what question comes in our mind? Cuts what? Okay, so what is our question? Now, this is, again, there is an object over here and the object is apple. So, cut what? Apple. Right? So, yes, we have an object because we are getting the answer with the question what. So the correct answer over here is transitive verb. Okay, so this is a transitive verb. Second one, rivers flow into the sea. Now flow is an action. Flow where? Okay, into the sea. But however, we are getting the question where. That means it is not a transitive, so it is a intransitive. The reason is it doesn't have an object. Next one, Maya recited a poem. Recited is an action, right? Recited what? A poem, right? So there is an object over here and the object is recited a poem, right? So children, this particular answer is transitive. Next one, she knocked at the door. Now what is the action over here, children? Knocked, right? Now knocked where? Okay, at the door, right? So that means this particular sentence doesn't have an object, so this is an intransitive verb. Okay, I hope you are clear with this. Now we will quickly practice more 5 sentences.
Now children, I'm very sure as you know the trick, the remaining 5 sentences you can give the answer and write the answer in your notebook. We will cross check with the correct answer. First sentence, birds flew away. Second, the dog chased the cat. Next, we took shelter under a tree. Next, the guard blew his whistle. Next, I heard a funny noise. Now let us see what is the correct answer, children. Birds flew away. Now what is the action, children? Flew. Okay, flew where? Okay, this is the question which comes in our mind. Away, right? So it doesn't have an object, that means it's an intransitive verb. Next one, the dog chased the cat. Chased is our action. Chased whom? Right? Okay, now it's a living thing and that's the reason the question will be whom. So we are getting an object over here, that's the cat. That means the answer is transitive. Next one, we took shelter under a tree. Okay, we took shelter. Shelter is also an action, children. So shelter where? Under a tree. So what is the question coming in our mind? Where? So it doesn't have an object and that's the reason it's an intransitive verb. The next one, the guard blew his whistle. Blew what? Whistle. So it has a object over here and it's a transitive one. Next, I heard a funny noise. What's the action, children? Heard. Question is what? Heard what? Funny noise. So it's a transitive verb. Okay, I'm very sure, children, with this trick it's very easy to identify whether the sentence is transitive or intransitive, isn't it? So now we will go ahead with the next one. Now children, we will finish off with the part 2 session over here. And today we have done transitive and intransitive verbs, which are really interesting. And we have also done, tricks to understand how to recognize the transitive and intransitive verbs. So yes, children, below the description box, there will be a worksheet. Make sure that you are going to fill this worksheet and send it across online. So till we meet again for part 3, children, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.